गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव स्टॉप्ड इन सेडिमेंटरी रॉक्स। वी हैव क्लोज्ड इन सेडिमेंटरी रॉक्स। हियर इन दिस वीडियो आई विल बी डीलिंग विद फर्स्ट इन सेडिमेंटरी रॉक्स। ओके, सो वी कैन ओवरलुक द प्रीवियस स्लाइड व्हाट आई हैव टॉट यू। स्टोन्स, एज वी नो, स्टोन्स हैव बीन कंसिडर्ड एज वन ऑफ द पॉपुलर बिल्डिंग मटेरियल from olden days, and it is derived from the rocks which are formed from the earthquake, and it has no definite shape. Okay, and these are the historical buildings, and these are made up of stones, and here these are the classifications of rock. I have told you classifications of rock, three types. There are geological, physical and chemical. Geological classifications, this classification is based on the formation of rocks, and physical classification is based on the appearance of the rock, and next is chemical classification. It's based on the rocks which contain chemicals. Okay, so in the I have told you geological classification is again categorized in three types. I have said igneous, sedimentary and metamorphic, and physical classification is again categorized in three types, that is stratified, unstratified and foliated rocks. And chemical classification is again categorized in three types, that is, you can say siliceous, argillaceous and calcareous rocks. Okay, as I have told you about the igneous rocks, it is formed by the cooling of magma and thus solidifying from the molten state. This first picture shows the magma when cools, it is known as igneous rocks. Okay, and the igneous rocks are the two types, you can say extrusive igneous rocks and intrusive igneous rocks. And as I told you, when the earth surface is a very high temperature, okay, and the magma tries to come out from the surfaces, and when the magma tries to come out above the surfaces, we can say that is extrusive igneous rocks, and the magma tries to cool below the surfaces, we can say it's intrusive igneous rocks. Okay, then the sedimentary rocks. Now we'll read about the sedimentary rocks. I have taught in the previous slide about the sedimentary rocks. Okay, I am explaining you again about the sedimentary rocks. Okay, sedimentary rocks means what? How the sedimentary rocks have been formed? Here is, you can see the picture of sedimentary rocks. Here you can see the picture of sedimentary rocks, and how the sedimentary rocks are formed. Sedimentary rocks are mainly formed by the depositions of materials by weathering agents. Okay, weathering agents, I have told you in the previous slide, weathering agents means what? Rain, forest, frost, wind, flowing water, these are the weathering agents. When the rain, flowing wind, water occurs, the rocks, the small types of rocks or the igneous rocks go out to a place, a settles up, and it forms a layer, and after that the layer of sedimentary rocks have been formed. Okay, you can see the picture here. Here the materials blown, the stones or pebbles that have been flown by the wind or flowing water, and it forms over time, the bottom layer turns into rock, then here the layer of sedimentary rocks have been formed. After that, plant and animal here dies. The here the sedimentary rocks have been formed. Okay, we can say the sedimentary rocks are formed through a sequence of processes, that is weathering, erosion, deposition, compaction and cementation. Okay, for example, we can say it, that is sandstone and limestone. Next is metamorphic rocks. Metamorphic rocks means what? Rocks are formed by the effect of heat and pressure on existing rocks. Here you can see the metamorphic rocks. Here is an example of metamorphic rocks, and the metamorphic rocks are mainly formed by the heating of magma. Okay, the heat from the magma, and after that the metamorphic rocks are formed here. You can see the metamorphic rocks are forming here. Okay, then for example, you can say that is marble, slate. Okay, these are the metamorphic rocks. Here, how the rocks are formed? I have told you the geological classification means what? Formation of the rocks. These rocks, how it is formed, means igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks and metamorphic rocks. How these three rocks have been formed. Okay, or we can say the rock cycle, we can say. Okay, here you can see when the earth surface is a very high temperature, inside portion is very of high temperature, the molten or pasty material comes out from the surfaces. This is known as magma. Here you can see this is known as magma, and the magma tries to flow above the surfaces and cools off. We can see that is known as extrusive igneous rocks, and some of the magma cools below the surfaces. We can see that is intrusive igneous rocks. Okay, you can see here. Okay, and this is how the igneous rocks have been formed. Then comes to sedimentary rocks. Okay, sedimentary rocks. After the igneous rocks is here formed, then after the weathering or weathering agents, we can say I have told you rain, flowing water, wind, frost. These are the weathering agents. When the rain, flowing water, wind flows here, and it transport to a layer, and it forms the sedimentation, compaction, and cementation forms, and the sedimentary rocks have been formed. Okay, you can see here the weathering, the form of the pebbles coming to a layer and coming to a place, and it forms a layer. Okay, transport and it forms a layer. You can say that is it is known as sedimentary rocks. Next, these sedimentary rocks have been formed. Next, we can say the metamorphic rocks form. How the metamorphic rocks are formed? Metamorphic rocks form in the heat and pressure from the igneous rocks and sedimentary rocks. The metamorphic, after hitting it, the metamorphic rocks have been formed. Okay, understood? The rock cycle, you understood the what are the how the rocks can be formed, how the igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks, and metamorphic rocks, how these three types of rocks form. You understood? Okay. Next, we will see about physical classifications. Physical classifications means what? I have told you the classification is based on the mode of appearance of the rocks, how the rocks appear. Okay. First, we can say there are three types. Again, categorized in three types. That is, first is stratified rocks, unstratified rocks, and foliated rocks. Stratified rocks means what? The rocks which can be easily split up. Okay. It can be easily split up. You can see the stratified rocks here. First figure you can see here. Stratified rocks, it can be easily split up. Okay. For example, we can say that is sandstone and limestone. Next is unstratified rocks. Unstratified rocks means what? The rocks which cannot easily be split up. For example, granite and marble. You can see the unstratified rocks here. The rocks which cannot be easily split up. Okay. Next is foliated rocks. The rocks have a tendency to be split up in a definite direction. These are the foliated rocks. An example of foliated rocks is genesis. Okay. Here you can see the foliated rocks. Okay. Foliated rocks, it can be split up in a definite direction. It can have definite direction. Okay. Next is chemical classification. Chemical classifications, I have told you about the classification is based on the mode of chemicals from which the rock, from what, which type of chemicals the rock contains. Okay. First we can say that is siliceous rocks. Siliceous rocks means what? The rocks which contain silica as a main constituent. Okay. The rocks which contain silica. Silica means, you know, it is one type of a chemical, and it contains in siliceous rocks. That is SiO2 as the main constituent. For example, we can say it as a granite and quaternite. Okay. Next is argillaceous rocks. What? Argillaceous rocks means what? The rocks which contain clay or alumina as the main constituent. Clay or alumina is one type of a chemical which is contained in the rock, and we can say that is known as argillaceous rock. Alumina, we can tell Al2O3. Okay. It is the main constituent, and it contains the rock which is known as argillaceous rocks. For example, we can say it slate and laterites. Okay. Next is calcareous rocks. What? What do you mean by calcareous rocks? Rocks which contain lime or calcium carbonate as the main constituent. Okay. Calcium carbonate is one type of the chemicals somewhere the rocks which contain chemicals, it is one of the main constituent. For example, we can say here limestone and marble. Okay, these are the, you can see here, this is one type of siliceous rocks which contains silica, and this is known as argillaceous rocks which is known contains alumina, and this contains calcareous rocks which contains chemicals, that is CaCO3. Okay, so in the next slide we will be delivering what are the uses of stones. Thank you.